So up in Oklahoma, you had Ron Paul supporters getting punched in the back and in the back of the head by Mitt Romney supporters. Man, these Mitt Romney supporters are so militant, aren't they? I mean, they're the most ignorant, militant group of people I've ever met in my life. Anyway, the Arizona GOP had their convention as well, and true to form, chaos ensued down there, too. So, Don, can you play the Arizona GOP convention clip for us, sir?
Thank you very much. I'm very appreciative of our state chairman and happy ever since he was elected. I'm here to speak for the platform Republicans running on the slate for national delegates. We are preserving our conservative principles in the Republican platform, which will be opened at the national convention and voted upon and debated. We want conservative representation. Appreciating the Constitution does not belong to one faction of the Republican Party. Our platform says that the Constitution aspires to reach the highest aspirations of humanity, so all us Republicans appreciate the Constitution. I'm asking for party unity. We're hearing a lot about unity. Please unite behind our written, agreed-upon, passed set of principles. That's our Republican platform. That's our purpose. You'll have conservative representation to preserve the conservative principles in the platform at the convention. Thank you very much.
Okay, so you can stop it. So I know that wasn't really all that chaotic. It wasn't nearly as entertaining as the woman getting punched or the man getting punched. But there was a lot in there that we need to cover. Now, this was evidently some representative for the GOP in Arizona, and he said some things that were very concerning, very alarming. First, he said, you know, we have to unite as Republicans, and that's kind of a given. That's, you know, standard message. You're at a Republican convention. The second thing he goes on to say is that the Constitution does not belong to one part of the GOP. Now, obviously, he's bringing up the fact that there's a great division within the GOP between Mitt Romney supporters and Ron Paul supporters. I mean, those are the only two candidates left running for the nomination, so that's exactly what he's talking about. Now, when he says that the Constitution doesn't belong to one part of the GOP, it makes us kind of raise our red flags and say, wait a second. Wait. You're looking at it backwards, GOP leader who's speaking to us from stage. Wouldn't you rather say to the candidates that the people are united around the Constitution? Now, you candidates are responsible for telling us why you do the same? See, this is where we're getting it wrong. This is where the party is just dropping the ball like little kids. Stop stumping for candidates who aren't good enough to lead. And that's exactly what you're doing. If Mitt Romney stood for the Constitution, believe me, constitutional-loving people would know about it. The fact is that he doesn't, and that's why you have to say things like, we all support the Constitution here. Everybody unite behind the Constitution here. Well, you know what, genius? The Democrats are going to say the exact same thing. I mean, how ignorant of an argument is that? And then he says, all Republicans appreciate the Constitution. The ignorance is almost getting offensive. You know how when you're in a room with a stupid person, you really can't stand to be in that room for more than 5 minutes? Well, for some of these people, they find themselves in that room, but they're all alone, and they still can't stand it. And then when they go up on stage and they just spew this ignorance, it's just almost offensive to everybody who can think that happens to be in the room. What party is going to get up there and say, we hate the Constitution, so now please unite behind us? No, they're all going to say we love the Constitution. It's kind of like all religions are going to say, hey, we love God, but are all religions the same? No, they're not all the same. So you really have to look at your facts here. You have to look at the people running. And the GOP knows something's up. When you have to remind people that your candidate supports the Constitution, newsflash, they don't. Sorry, that's just the way it goes. Now, like I said, Mitt Romney's son, Josh, made it to Arizona in order to stump for his father. We have a Fox News clip from that. It plays that, but it also carries out this little conversation afterwards. And it just shows that these people on Fox, these experts that they put in front of the media cameras, they just don't get it. Don, if you could please, sir.
Well, the supporters of Ron Paul not showing a lot of love to the son of Governor Mitt Romney. According to the Arizona Republic, Josh Romney was speaking at the Arizona Republican Party convention trying to win support for his father's nomination. But the audience of GOP members having none of it, booing Josh Romney off the stage. Take a listen.
When my dad realized that he was going to be the next Republican nominee for President of the United States of America, I was actually with him.
Okay, pause it there, Don. Pause it there before we get to their commentary. Okay, so here you just heard Josh. We started out this clip with the Fox News commentator saying that the Ron Paul supporters not showing a lot of love for Josh Romney down there in Arizona as they boo him off the stage. Take a listen. So we take a listen, and we're expecting, you know, the Ron Paul supporters not to show a lot of love. But in reality, what really happened? See how easy it is for the media to flip things? It wasn't the Ron Paul supporters not showing a lot of love. It was Josh Romney and the Romney campaign not showing a lot of love for the GOP convention, the people who are attending the GOP convention, and the supporters of the other candidate. So if anybody really wasn't showing love, if anybody was slapping the face of somebody else, it was Mitt Romney smacking the GOP, saying, ha, 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 GOP, I don't respect you or your unity message. I know you like to say that from stage, and I know somebody just said it before me from the Arizona GOP, but now once I get up there, I'm going to have my representative, which happens to be my son, just spit on the face of you, your unity, your constitution, this convention, and everybody in attendance, and say, well, when my dad was the presumptive nominee, and that's why people booed. The reason they booed, you idiots, is because they were at the GOP convention to decide who the state was going to present as the nominee. And when somebody has the audacity, the rudeness, the heartlessness, the soullessness, the immaturity to stand up there and say, when my dad became the presumptive nominee, when my dad, then of course you're going to get people booing. Because it's a lack of respect. It's a lack of manhood. It's a lack of adulthood. And we are sick and tired of it. How rude. How rude, and I'm sure the Mitt Romney campaign issued an apology today. If they didn't, then they need to. And I know, I'm probably spiking the little needle over there at GCN, but I'm just sick and tired of these lunatics going out there and saying stuff that spits in the face of people, and then after they smack you, they remind you, well, get behind me in unity, please. No! No! If you're not behind the people should not get behind you, and if you continue to just spew this evil crap, then I'm going to continue to stand up for the people and say, no, don't do it. Don't get behind them. Don't do this party loyalty, when in reality all the candidate is really doing is just spanking you. They're spanking you and asking you if you like it. And that's got to stop. And I get it. Well, Josh, you're attacking a candidate's its child. I thought children were off limits. No. Children are off limits if they're going to be children. If the candidate decides to put his son up on stage, then it's the candidate's fault. We'll be back right after this. Alright, Arizona has their GOP convention. One of the leaders of the Arizona GOP gets up there and starts talking about how everybody needs to unite and get behind, blah, 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 bunch of kumbaya stuff. And then Josh Romney gets up there and spits on the face of the GOP, all that kumbaya stuff, spanks the Ron Paul supporters, and then Fox News says, oh, Ron Paul supporters not showing a lot of love. Well, of course you're not going to show a lot of love to somebody who just slapped you. I mean, that's just stupid. If they're not going to show a lot of love to you, if they're going to show a lot of disrespect, a lot of hate towards you, a lot of hate towards the process, a lot of hate towards the office that they're trying to win this November, well, then obviously you're not going to show them a lot of love. I mean, get real. Anybody who can't respect the office of president doesn't deserve to be president, so that's just kind of obvious. But the wonderful pundits over at Fox News just don't seem to get it, and they commented after they played the clip, so let's comment on their comments. Don, if you could please, sir.
Josh is the third of Mitt Romney's five sons, by the way. He tried to calm the crowd down, but was repeatedly cut short. So does this spell big trouble for Governor Romney in his effort to wrap up the nomination? Let's bring in our power panel to discuss. Judith Miller, Pulitzer Prize-winning investigative reporter, author, and Fox News contributor. Patricia Powell,
so stupid,
the founder and CEO of Powell Financial Group. And Deneen Borelli, a columnist for The Daily Caller and a Fox News contributor. Thank you all for joining us. us today on this Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day.
Yes. So, Judy, I'll start with you here. What do we think, first of all, does Ron Paul hope to accomplish with the Republican National Convention? And then what do his supporters hope to accomplish?
Well, I think that Ron Paul probably didn't get the one big tent memo. I mean, look, if I'm President Obama sitting in the White House, I'm delighted by this. I mean, who needs to run negative ads when you have Republicans beating up on Republicans? I just think the time has come, if you're a Republican, to kind of put whatever grievance you have about the front runner aside and hang together, but that's clearly not what's not going on.
Yeah.
And they are very, I understand they feel passionately, but you know, the time has come.
Yeah, and Ron Paul says, though, he's going all the way through to Tampa to the convention. So, Patricia, what do you think?
Well, you know, I think really the problem is Romney, though. I think the problem is Romney hasn't found his voice, and he hasn't said to these people, I love your passion, and I have worked very hard to be the nominee of this party, and you're not going to like everything I say, and you're not going to like everything I do, but you're going to like what I do and what I say a heck of a lot better than 4 more years of a failed Obama experiment.
So shut them up, please, because, I mean, obviously we see the same continuation of stupidity. It's just on a different channel. Same program, different channel. Unreal. So first they said, well, you know what? What didn't Ron Paul get? And that lady says, well, Ron Paul didn't get the big tent memo. Excuse me? Excuse me. Ron Paul's the one that didn't get the big tent memo? Well, let's see. Let's just kind of analyze this for a second. The biggest tent happens to be the one where people love liberty, love freedom, love the Constitution, and love integrity. Now, the big tent also happens to be attracting a lot of people. Ron Paul brings the biggest number of people over from, or biggest amount of people over from the Democrat side. He brings the largest amount of people from the independents, largest amount of people from the moderates, and a huge, huge percentage of the GOP themselves. So if anybody didn't get the large party or the large tent memo, it would be Mitt Romney. Mitt Romney is still playing his small tent message. He's still playing the message of, hey, if you hate America, come join me. Hey, if you hate the Constitution, I'm the guy for you. And then they try to wrap it and say, well, if you're really conservative, you're going to want to vote for us. And then this whole, the time has come. The time has come for us to hang together. What? Wait. Again, I think we have it backwards. The candidates are supposed to represent the people. The people want to be free. So now the media pundits and all these quote-unquote experts are telling us, no, forget what all the people want. No, there is a candidate. There's a guy out there running for office, and he wants to promote things like NDAA 2012 and the Patriot Act and all these other neocon, neolib, globalist agenda items. And What we need to do now is we all need to sacrifice what the group wants, and we need to unite behind this one lunatic. Let's unite against this guy. That's the time has come for us all to give up on what America is and unite. Unite against Mitt Romney. I mean Barack Obama. I mean Mitt Romney. Ugh. Makes you just want to puke. And then, you know, they go on and there's laughter. Yes. Yeah, about the convention. Yeah, Ron Paul trying to, what does he want to do at the convention? Well, it's time we get behind him. And then the other lady starts to go the right way. Well, I think Romney's missing it. Okay, yes. Please expound upon that. Well, I think Mitt Romney's missing that. He hasn't found his voice yet. And he has to get to the point where he says, you might not like me, and you might not like what I'm going to do, but you're certainly not going to like what the other guy's going to do. Wait a second. Why on earth would we settle for that? Why on earth? So first we start out with finding a voice. Mitt Romney hasn't found his voice. Well, you know why he hasn't found his voice? Because he doesn't have a platform of which he can actually speak from. He doesn't have enough character and track record to actually stand upon something and people believe him when he says it. It's not that he doesn't have a voice. He has a voice, and he's actually very good at orating. He's very good at debates. He's very good at presenting himself, but nobody believes him, and that's the problem. We've seen him flip-flop so often that you really don't know where he stands. So it's not that he doesn't have a voice. He doesn't have a platform that the people can rally behind. And a platform that people can rally behind is not something you can just create anymore. You know, when you're running for office in the 80s and 90s and even the early 2000s, you could get away with creating a platform a couple weeks before people start going to the polls because people were stupid and we didn't have access to all the recorded data so easily available at our fingertips. So you could say, yeah, well, I've always been for America. I've always been for the Constitution. Well, now they can YouTube your butt. We can find out, well, you know what, right before you got to this bus stop, the previous bus stop, you said something completely different, and the media kept pointing it out. The media joked about it. Well, which Mitt Romney are we going to get now? So in reality, the people are just sick and tired of the Mitt Romneys of the world. They're tired of these people who have no backbone, who have no moral fortitude. And you know what's really funny? I had a one-way conversation. Funny how that happens. I had a one-way conversation with somebody. I believe it was Saturday. And this person is a Mitt Romney supporter. Yes, I finally met one. I wanted to take a picture. It's like finding Bigfoot. Anyway, I found a Mitt Romney supporter. And the discussion was revolving around how they couldn't find anything on Mitt Romney. Well, you can't find anything on Mitt Romney unless you go all the way back to school. They're going back to his school records to find out that he bullied somebody one day. Talk about a great candidate. They can't find anything on this guy. And I was sitting there thinking, wait a second. Wait. How can you say they can't find anything on this guy? All you have to do is go back a week. I mean, this guy has such low character indicators. And, you know, from a professional standpoint, as a behavioral strategist, you kind of look at Mitt Romney and say, wow, you are one messed up dude. But anyway, you go back in his past and you see how he flip-flops on abortion. You see how he flip-flops on guns. You see how he flip-flops on taxes. You see, I mean, you have to go back a week maybe. Maybe even a week. I would argue maybe this morning, but you can go back a week and find something that he's dropped on. He's not a man of character. He's not a man of substance. He's Barack Obama with a little R after his name. And we're going to talk about Barack Obama, too, as we continue with this. But to have a convention where a candidate's son gets up there and just slaps everybody, to have a convention in Oklahoma where you think it's okay to punch people in the head because they don't like your candidate, that should tell you that you, the puncher, are voting for the wrong guy. When you have to punch people, when you have to start turning off the lights, when you have to start dividing the room, when half of the party is outside because they can't be in the same room with you, that's not unity. You are creating a very small tent, GOP. Very small tent. All right, we'll be back right after this.